How could a judge grant him bail?
I have no idea.
Okay, class, so far we've explored ethical questions in the theoretical. But today we'll dive into something a little more empirical. Based on experience, your own, and humanity as a whole, should we make decisions for other people without their consent? And if so, when and how? Welcome back, Tariq. Would you like to get us started today?
Well, whether we like it or not, decisions are made for people without their consent all the time. It's a fact of life.
Like a professor exploiting a student.
Did you have something to say, Lauren?
Just according to Harm Principle, the only purpose for which power can be rightfully exercised over any member of a civilized community against his will is to prevent harm to others.
Yeah, but who has the authority to determine what harm is? And to say who's the victim.
Right, like with the police. The authorities might argue that the use of brute force is to protect the citizens from harm, but in reality, they're actually the perpetrators.
Yeah, and that happens everywhere. People in power are constantly making decisions for us without our consent.
Elected officials.
Voters give elected officials consent.
And then politicians make shady deals behind their backs.
What about media outlets?
Shit. Stansfield makes decisions for students all the time. Dorm raids, anyone?
Yeah, like what happened to Lauren. It was so unfair.
Uncool, yes, but not unfair. People consent to be a part of the system. Lauren signed the student housing agreement like the rest of us. So if you're gonna have drugs in your dorm, you gotta be smart enough to not get caught with it.
Or Stansfield needs to stop targeting BIPOC students to drag down to the police station.